This is what text-to-video is now capable of. And from today, you can get access to Runway ML Gen 2. In this video, I'm going to break down what's now possible and show you how to get the best out of this new technology. Once you've signed up to Runway ML, you get a free trial. And if you come onto their page, you'll be able to go straight in to generate a video with a text prompt. So you can put in anything you like here. If you scroll down, there are a number of examples, which are good starting points because you know they're going to get a good render from. So I suggest you come down and you try out any of these that take your fancy. So I particularly like this mountain scene. And you can see that it puts in an example prompt for you to play around with. What we have is an aerial drone shot of a mountain range in the style of cinematic video. Shallow depth of field, subject in focus, dynamic movement. And all you have to do is go ahead and press generate. So currently you get about 120 seconds free, which equates to around 40 different short videos. At the moment, it's exporting fairly quickly for a video. It's not quite as fast as an image generation, but you can see here that it will take around 1 minute, depending on how busy the servers are. So whilst that is rendering, you can also open it in a new tab and render out other videos simultaneously. So I've opened a new tab and I'm going to pop in my own prompt here. And for that, I will try something simple like underwater neon jellyfish dancing to techno. So whilst that one is rendering, we can come back to our initial mountain shot. And you can see it has loaded. And you can scroll down to press play. And there we can see. So let's take a look at our neon jellyfish. Oh boy, that is looking like a dancy little trippy jellyfish. Hello, sir. Now, another cool thing you can do is you can use an image as a prompt. And to do that, all you have to do is come to the right-hand side and click on the little image box. Now, one thing that I've been enjoying doing is taking an image from Midjourney, saving it. I'm using this futuristic African face-painted lady, and I'm going to upload it. So you select upload, go to the drag-and-drop box, choose your image to upload. And I have found this to work quite similarly to Midjourney's image prompting feature. So it will give you some sort of resemblance, but by no means it completely outputs a coherent replica of the image that you use. But it's also useful to add in a prompt that enhances the likeness to the image you're putting in. So I can actually even take the prompt that I was using in Midjourney and use this as my prompt, whilst adding as a verb. So I give it a little bit of action. Now I can go ahead and press generate. So I added speaking as my verb. Now, whilst that's rendering, I will tell you my top tips for using Runway ML. Number one is use an illustrative style rather than trying to achieve a realistic output. Number two, make sure you're putting in an image as a base and try to get a number of different iterations to make sure you're getting the best possible output. Beyond this, you can take your prompting skills from Midjourney or other AI art generators and apply them in the same way to Runway ML. So make sure you're defining the style, the type of camera, the shot, and the composition. And you'll start to get a feel for what works well and what doesn't. So abstract, moving images with some dynamic elements are great, whereas very realistic faces are very bad. So that is the spectrum. But if we go through some of the previews they show in their tutorial video, you can see some really excellent outputs coming out. Now, it'll be interesting to see how they got such a high quality output, because a lot of my attempts did not match the coherence that we see in this image. Like, you can see this cat, there is pretty much nothing wrong, I would say, with the composition, the proportions, or the lighting. Even the whiskers look well-defined and in sensible positions. I mean, there's no whiskers coming out of the eyes. And yet, they're saying that the only input they put was cat experiencing the cosmos. So I will try that out myself as well, just to see what we get. So let's take a look at our cat experiencing the cosmos. And you can see that my cat is not quite as coherent as theirs, as mine only has, well, it either has three legs and no tail, or one leg, a strange tail, and a stump. But let's play it and see. Well, it's quite engaging, but obviously there are some serious defects in the coherence of our dear little pussycatty. So let's also try a palm tree on a tropical beach, as they have demonstrated in their example. You can see that this palm tree is a lot more similar to the one that they showed in the example. So it does give me hope that they are not just completely having us on with an absolute marketing ploy. We can come back and see how the image of the woman came out. You can see here that it's given her quite a broad face. Next up, I input this sad cyborg, and this was the version I got out. You can see that there is some noise and quite a lot of distortion to the image, but it's kept something of the aesthetic, the tone, the feel. But I've been playing around with trying to get some more illustrative images from Midjourney, which I'm going to be using in Runway, because things that are slightly more abstract, more painted, they come out a lot better in Runway ML. So I've got these buildings and this swan, and I'm going to give these a go. Now, if you want to play along too, I recommend this is the best workflow. Once you've created your images, you've saved them, you can come back into Runway ML, come into the Gen 2 model and upload your new images and put in a simple text prompt that relates to your image. Make sure to include a verb. Here I've used dancing, the dancing swan. Ain't no swan like a dancing swan. Ain't no swan like a dancing swan. So I'm going to open Runway in a new tab so I can work on a few concurrent jobs to speed up the workflow. And this time I will upload my beautiful painted lighthouse. This time I will simply add night time lapse. Now there are a few more options that you can explore, but these are upgraded features. So if you do want to upgrade, you do have the opportunity to upscale, because currently the resolution that you get out is a fairly low 768 by 448 pixels. The other thing that you get is much longer videos. So with the free version, you get a maximum of 4 seconds. With the upgraded version, you get up to 15 seconds per video generation. And of course, you get to remove the watermark. So I'll get this one to generate and let's come back to, oh God, I closed my tab. Oh, it was not a one that was important. Whew, thank God for that. Thank God for reopened tab. Okay, let's have a look at our dancing swan. Ladies and gentlemen, I introduce to you the world's first international performance of Gigi Swan. So it's very elegant, it lacks a lot of movement, and there are some strange artifacts of watermarks in the corner. But what you can do is regenerate, and I'll show you what happens if you regenerate with the same image and the same prompt. It's actually quite interesting. But whilst that loads, we'll come back to see our delightful, magnanimous night time lapse. And this is quite a beautiful instance here, though it has lost a lot of the painterly feel. So I will add in a few extra keywords to refine the image and the video closer to what I had in mind. So now I've added in the illustrated Van Gogh style, and you see we're getting closer to the image style and what we had in mind. It's starting to look pretty good actually. And it's certainly a style, an image, a appropriate aesthetic choice that could work really well for actually crafting a story, a narrative, an entire film. So the possibilities to be using this in your own YouTube videos, for your own short films, for music videos, for marketing is really endless. And if you look at how we rendered the second version of our dancing techno swan, you can see that this time it's absolutely beautiful. It really is quite a mesmerizing scene and gives us a great idea of what is possible. So let me show you a few more experiments that I had. Here's a macro of an eye. This is a drone shot of a cyberpunk city. Here is a nature time lapse. It was interesting that this one actually split the scene in two, and I did not inform it to do that. And here is a man and a goat. Here are some other examples from other people, and you can see there are some sci-fi spaceships working really well. This guy, Nick Float, has created a number of excellent works that I'm very impressed with, especially these abstract neon textures and working these into a more coherent narrative. Here are a few more examples that were particularly impressive. Here is a jungle river being rendered in excellent detail, and now a jungle waterfall during the day, and a desert oasis, and these grasses, as well as this roaring campfire. But what I really like about these grass in the wind is the attention to detail, the coherence in the image, as well as the lighting, really capturing the highlights on the individual strains. Now, there are a couple of other interesting models that you can use inside of Runway ML. If we take a look at their preview video.
model that allows you to use words and images to generate new videos out of existing ones. In the week since launching, the model.
So they're demonstrating how they have evolved from Runway 1, which was impressive, but the images and videos coming out were quite honestly very abstract, to put it politely. They were absolute rubbish.
Better temporal consistency.
So here he mentions that the improvement in temporal consistency has increased immensely. And this relates to how well different frames connect. So if you have a frame at the start and a few frames later, how well do they actually relate to each other? So this makes sure that the machine actually creates a video that is coherent and understandable.
See, better fidelity.
Fidelity is relating to the exactness or the quality of video that is being produced.
Better results. And as more and more people gained access, we unlocked entirely new use cases and displays of creativity. And today, we're excited to announce our biggest unlock yet. Text to video.
So this is what we all have access to now, the wonderful text to video engine.
With Gen 2. Now you can generate a video with nothing but words. No driving video, no input image. Gen 2 represents yet another major research.
So basically before with Gen 1, you had to use a base image or a base video and it would overlay new types of styles to that to get you a new video. But now we can start with just a text prompt, which is a huge leap forwards.
Search milestone and another monumental step forward for generative AI. With Gen 2, anyone, anywhere can suddenly realize entire worlds.
So this gives us a whole host of new capabilities and possibilities to generate our own moving images. As you can see from a lot of these examples, I think the best use cases for creating video is for stylistic interpretations. So for creating animated, painted, illustrative videos, rather than trying to achieve realistic outputs. And let's put that into action ourselves and try a few more of the exciting modes available. Another awesome mode to try out is the video to video. And if you come here from the homepage, select video to video, and then upload your own video, I shall be using a video of me on a toy horse. What I do in my spare time is none of your business. Pegasus, it's time to go to dinner. So you can scroll down and you can apply a stylistic image. So this will overlay the style from one image and put that onto the video. Let's show you the example of that from Runway ML's previews. You can see here, this is the base video. This was the image they included. And together you have this dancing fire man. So there is a set of demo images that they also allow you to choose from. You do have the fire or the cyberpunk options. I will try the cyberpunk option. Now you can come down and you can adjust the style strength. That's essentially how much of the image style is applied to the video. More image style makes it more like the image. I will leave it on 50% and go ahead and select generate video. So let's come back and see how I'm getting on riding my cyberpunk unicorn. And we can take a look. That is pretty disturbing. So I then took this image of me throwing an axe.
Yeah.
And turned it into a Viking.
Yeah.
And you can see that's a fairly interesting
composition
that's come out from there. However, the details and the artifacts do prevent it from being potentially incredibly usable. Now, there are a couple of other interesting models that you can use inside of Runway ML. One is that you can mask different areas. For example, you can take this little golden retriever and turn him into a Dalmatian. So if you're bored with your dog, you can change it to a different breed. The other one you can do is you can take untextured renders and ask it to apply textures and extra atmosphere to your scenes. For example, here they've taken this swimming gentleman and added bubbles and colors. So I saw this one example on Instagram of this guy dancing and being turned into a Greek god. And you can see it's worked really well. There are other AI powered features inside of Runway ML that are also worth checking out. For example, the removal of the background, which automatically identifies the subject and removes them from the background. This can be great for actually building out scenes and rendering them separately and then combining them later. You also have an option to use a text-to-image generator. So if you want to build your own images and use those within your video generation, so it's entirely possible inside of Runway ML. And if you do want to upgrade, they have a pretty handsome option for a standard plan. It's $12 a month and you get 625 credits a month, which is roughly 625 seconds. You're able to buy more credits on a pay-as-you-go basis, and you get to upscale the resolution and remove watermarks, which are great features for allowing you to actually use your work commercially. Of course, you get up to 15 seconds, unlimited project, 100 gigabytes of asset storage, and you're allowed up to 7 people to edit on the same project. If you go all the way up to the pro model, you get 2,250 credits and 500 gigabytes of asset storage. And that's the main difference between the plans. There is also an iOS app version of Runway ML, so you can actually do this on your iPhone. It has some mixed reviews. Some people are blown away. Wow, I must say, I was blown away. Oh, somebody needs to get out of the house a bit more. Oh. This app is truly a game changer in the world of video creation. Somebody was definitely paid to write a review. No. First up, it takes forever just to set up the app and go through an endless registration process where I am asked a million questions and 3 of my emails being denied because of not being accepted. You can see that this person is just rather difficult. So do try the iOS app out if you want to use it on your phone. I can't wait to see where this technology goes. I've also just started a newsletter, so if you're interested in getting weekly updates on the latest AI news from yours truly, make sure to sign up below. And thanks for watching.